Welcome to Engineering Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will talk about Python statements, identifiers, keywords, and buildings. In Python, a command is referred to as a statement. For example, this print hello world command is a statement. Python will evaluate this statement and return the result. This print function just displays whatever you put inside this pair of parentheses verbatim. This is another statement. Python will return the result of 4 plus 5. The result is 9. We can execute several statements together in sequence. For example, we can print the word hello, then world, and then the result of 4 plus 5, which is 9. A Python identifier is the name of a variable, function, or module used in a program. Every identifier must begin with a letter or an underscore, followed by any sequence of letters, digits, or underscores. This statement, x equals 3, means identifier x now represents a value 3. After variable x is assigned a value, we can refer to the value by its name. Just type in x, it will return the value it represents, which is 3. This is the identifier of another variable. It starts with an underscore. This is a valid identifier. This example is another identifier. It has a letter x followed by a number 1. This is not a legal identifier because it starts with a number. Neither is this one because it starts with a special character, the plus sign. This is not a legal identifier because it contains another special character, the at sign. I want to repeat this. Every identifier must begin with a letter or an underscore followed by any sequence of letters, digits, or underscores. No special characters. Identifiers are case sensitive. That means a lowercase letter and an uppercase letter are not the same. For example, we give three different values, 10, 20, and 30, to three different variables. Later, when we show these variables, lowercase letter a is equal to 10, uppercase letter a is equal to 20, the underscore lowercase letter a is 30. Similarly, these three prices are not the same. The first one has an uppercase letter P, the second one has all lowercase letters, and the last one has an uppercase letter R. After we assign different values to them and show them later, they hold different numbers. This is 7.15, this is 8.15, and this is 9.15. Python has many reserved keywords. You should avoid using these keywords as identifiers in your own program. Keywords are also case sensitive. For a complete list of all the Python keywords, we can import the keyword library and then print keyword.keywlist. You will see these keywords. For example, the keyword for is used for loops. The keyword if is used to check conditions. If you try to assign a value 40 to 4, you will see a syntax error. It says invalid syntax because 4 is the reserved keyword. Similarly, if you try to assign value 50 to if, you will see another syntax error. However, if we change the case of these two English words to include an uppercase letter F and an uppercase letter I, these two statements will be fine. This is because they're different from the lowercase keywords. In addition to the keywords, Python also has many built-in functions and constants that are used for special purposes. It is recommended to avoid using these built-ins as your own identifiers. We can see the complete list of all the Python built-ins using the following statement: print dir underscore underscore built-ins underscore underscore. Python can show many different types of error messages if your input is not valid. For example, we have already seen the syntax error. Following these errors are some constants and built-in functions. For example, len is a Python function that returns the length of an object. In this case, we have a string, some text. The length is a number of characters, including spaces, this string contains, which is 9. If we use len as a variable name and assign 10 times 20 to it, it will store the value 200. But later when we try to use len as a function to get the length of a string, it gives us an error, because len is no longer the built-in function anymore. That is why we should avoid using these built-ins as our own identifiers. To reuse the len function, we can delete the variable len using the keyword del like this. After this variable is deleted, we can use the original len function again and calculate the length of the string. If we want to clear all the variables from the memory, we can use the Jupyter Notebook magic %reset. It will prompt, once deleted, variables cannot be recovered. Proceed, yes or no. Type in Y to confirm. After it's done, we can no longer access the previously defined variables, like this price. Spaces are irrelevant within an expression. For example, x space equals space 5 is equivalent to x equals 5 with no space. We just assign 5 to variable x. x4 spaces **2 is equivalent to x**2 with no spaces. Double stars are used as a power operator. In this case, it means x^2 or x², which is 25. You cannot use a variable without value assigned to it first. For example, we didn't use x2 anywhere in the previous commands. So when we try to print x2, it shows a name error. x2 is not defined. Okay, I just briefly talked about Python statements, identifiers, keywords, and built-ins. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.